Hey, it's Peter Holtz, CPA, with letter E of the ABCs of the new tax law. E is for expectation. Now, a lot of people are asking me right now, what do you think this means? What's going to happen with the new tax law? Well, the Tax Foundation is one of the country's oldest nonprofits studying income tax policy, and they were founded in 1937. And they analyzed the new tax law, and they believe basically that the new tax law will spur a 1.7% increase in the gross domestic product, 1.5% higher wages, and 339,000 new full-time jobs. Overall, what they believe it will do is it will lead to economic expansion. Now, a lot of times you hear in the news right now, hey, this tax bill is going to cost $1.5 trillion, and that's a static estimate. That means if the economy didn't change, this tax bill would cost that. Under their estimates, which also for static is $1.5 trillion over the next 10 years, if you look at a dynamic expectation, which means that because there's going to be more money in the economy is expected to grow. Therefore, more tax revenue is going to be generated just off growth of the economy. When you think about that and that growth and taking that into impact, you are looking at a total cost of about $400 billion, according to their estimates. So it's basically a $1 trillion difference when you factor in the growth. And that's kind of a lot of money. But anyway, you know, overall, I think this is going to spur some good growth in the economy. And, you know, when they talk about the repatriation of money that foreign, that big companies have overseas, there's a 15.5% tax bracket on that. And so that allows the companies to bring it back to the United States. Well, they went even a little bit further than that. If you don't bring it back to the United States, they're going to tax you anyway. So that's part of the new tax law, is that 15.5% repatriation tax. So that should help bring more money back into the United States and help our growth further. It's, you know, it's hard to tell. I remember that in 1986, there was a large tax reform put forth, and that did lead to fantastic growth in the economy through the late 80s and early 90s. So I'm expecting good things. I'm expecting people to make more investment. And one of the reasons I really expect that is because, you know, whenever small business owners have to pay more in tax, okay, and 67% of jobs are created by small business owners, whenever you got to pay more tax, you have less money in your bank, the first thing you have to do is cut back on people, cut back on hours, because that's one of the biggest things that we spend money on. If it goes the other way and you pay less tax, entrepreneurs, small business owners are going to invest more in their businesses because they believe that they can make them grow and make more money. And that's what we do as entrepreneurs, is we take money and we put it to use to make more money. It's really the creation of profits in a bigger and bigger business. So I really expect positive things from this new tax law. I think that's the general economics. It's worked that way before. Things are rapidly changing in our economy with the maturity of the internet and cloud-based systems, like I've talked about a lot before, and many, many different things happening. So I think my expectations are very positive 2018. I think as people really begin to understand the tax law, they'll be more aggressive in their planning for the future. So stay tuned. We'll continue to cover the ABCs through the next 20-some days. Thanks. Talk to you later.